So we sat there on the gymnasium floor the other day, all the students and staff of St. Francis Xavier High School, to listen to a little old lady. She had a story to tell us. She was just what you would expect a little old lady telling stories to be like. Short, frail, kind of cute in her own way. Charming. She talked very slowly, very carefully. She told us, "I have nice legs," we laughed. She was kind of like a grandma, you know, that we'd all sit around to hear fairy tales told to us by. But this was not a happy story that she was about to tell us. Her name was Dr. Eva Olsson. She started talking about bullying. "How many people here have been bullied?" she asked. A few of us put up our hands. She talked so slowly at first, many of us fast-paced individuals wondered when she was going to get to the point. Several minutes later, as she went on, some of us started to twitch, as young people often do, like myself. The gym floor and the bleachers, they were uncomfortable. Just as a stir of irritation was about to set in, she noticed us there and told us about her uncomfortable ride. Packed into a train car like cattle, standing room only, for 4 straight days, with only 2 pails of water for the entire crowd, as her family journeyed from their home in Hungary to a little place in Poland called Auschwitz. And from that moment on, for the next 90 minutes, we were transfixed. Even with 800 plus students, you could hear a pin drop in the gym. Eva Olsson is a survivor of the Shoah, or as it's known to most of us, the Holocaust of World War II, having been through Auschwitz and Bergen-Belsen concentration camps. She described the Third Reich, the Nazi movement led by Adolf Hitler, in a way that I had never thought of it before. They were the ultimate bullies. And it's true when you think about it. What motivates a person to bully? Usually they're fearful and insecure, so choose to feel powerful by hurting other people, particularly weaker people. Then they get addicted to the rush that they get from it and justify it by convincing themselves that those they abuse are less than human in some way, with convenient labels like nerd, geek, fag, slut, words of hate. The same mentality, taken to its ultimate extreme, is exactly what the world saw during the Shoah, the Holocaust. Nazis, the ultimate bully. That'll make you think twice about bullying someone again, won't it? So she told us her story, and we did not like what we heard. She told us of the death trains, packed to overflowing, with some people dying of exhaustion on the way. She told us of the men and young women marched off to slave labor, living on one bowl of potato skin soup and a cup of coffee per day. We heard about the gas chambers, women, children, elders stripped of their clothes and herded to their deaths, and the ovens burning night and day, filling the air with the ash of human remains. We heard about SS soldiers being instructed to shoot babies as they were held by their mothers, so that they can kill them both at the same time and save bullets. We heard about the shoes, the clothes, the toys, the glasses, the gold teeth left behind. We heard about the SS socks made of human hair. Some of us, I think, would very much have liked to close our ears. But we knew we had to hear it. And we knew that this woman had earned the right to be heard. And we need to hear it. As I got ready to write this talk, I did a Google search. Eva Olsson's website was easy to find. EvaOlsson.ca, piece of cake. But what was also easy to find, in the same Google search, just a few lines down, a website of Holocaust deniers. A hollow hoax, they called it. It was people who don't believe it happened. Don't believe that people could be so evil. And so, the bullying continues. Thing is, they can be so evil. Or more accurately, we can be so evil. Eva was asked by a student, how does one keep their faith after going through all the horrors that she had lived through? She told us, I don't blame God, she said. God didn't make Auschwitz. Evil men made Auschwitz. So we need to hear, and we need to look and see what we are capable of if we let our baser instincts take over, if we get addicted to the power rush of hurting others, if we let evil people get away with their crimes, if we remain silent, if we let the darkness that lives inside of all of us take over. We have to look at the cross of Jesus Christ for the same reason. There on the cross, we see all the hate, all the crime, all the torture and rape and anguish and horror and racism and evil that we are capable of visiting upon each other. Look so that it won't ever happen again.